Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to make a water foam in overlapping areas. First, let's open the water material we made last time. To blend the foam with the existing water material, a leap node is created, and the texture to be used as the foam is also imported. Then, to calculate the distance between the material and the surrounding surface, create a distance to the nearest surface node to express the nearest area as a foam. And multiply it by a constant to set the distance value. Note that in order for this node to work properly, you need to go into the Rendering tab in Project Settings and enable Generate Mesh Distance Fields in Lighting. Next, we connect the clamp node to limit the color. After that, connect the watercolor to B and the distance to nearest surface node to alpha as shown in the video on the previously created lerp node. Next, copy and paste the nodes which were previously used in the normal to make the foam move. Again, this changes the names so that the variables do not overlap. Then, we connect it to the texture which was already created. Next, create two constant 3 vector nodes to determine the inner and outer colors of the foam color and change them to parameters. Create one minus node, get the black and white values of the foam, invert the values, and set the alpha value of the lerp node to blend the foam. After that, connect to lerp to which the previous watercolor was connected. And then to emissive color. Now, when you look at the water on the world map, you will see the foam in the area where it overlaps the wall. You can see that it looks more natural by adjusting the inner color and speed of the foam in the material instance.